While we've been producing, we haven't had anybody looking over us and saying, you know, we're the record label, this is what we expect the style to be. It's just been the two of us, and it's been great. There's no such thing as a bad idea. And it's the big advantage just having the whole record in two heads. Tom said before that he thinks I write pop songs, but they're not pure pop. There's a little bit of experimentalism in them as well. So some of the songs do come out as singles, luckily, that can make it to radio. And some of the songs come out as more interesting.
Basic theme of the album is that we wanted percussion, but we didn't want drums. And then it's also a challenge to create the same effect or something close to a drum set without using a drum set. But nowadays you just have a computer and you have a sound card and you have a microphone, you can go wherever you want.
It's very, very personal and intimate music, you know, and it's taking a risk if you put it in this context, which it is in the context of pop music. I mean, it's a big challenge because it's a lot different than just putting a bass player and a guitar player and a drummer behind him and saying, okay, the songs go straight through like this.
Cello's recommended by my girlfriend and Alex, you know, we played together, Alex the bass player, and clarinet I found in an advert in a shop window, and trumpet was recommended by the violinist. The French horn was the hardest to find, and I really had to hunt to find the French horn player. The cello became a very important instrument. I mean, we'd both just kept saying, oh, what about cello, oh, what about cello, and then we had picking cello and then we had bow cello, and it seemed to be in a lot of songs. It's in about half the songs, isn't it? Mm. And Red Ribbon is where we use it the best.
The soil is full of clay, we left the sands on land and day.
I wanted to communicate this mood of struggle and conflict in a different way than just from the first person, and I decided to make this story of a couple that met before World War II and fell in love and agreed to be married and then were separated. Because when you watch these documentaries about the war, it's easy sometimes to think of the people as just as soldiers, because that's how they're presented, isn't it? That you're given a uniform so that you don't think about that body as a person. But behind that, everyone has a story and everybody is a tradesman or whatever. So I came up with the fact that the guy was a gardener, and that when he's running across the trenches and you know, when he's landing on D-Day and things like that, and he's not really thinking about the war, he's thinking, oh, the soil's very sandy, you know, and but now it's more clay, and he looks at the world from a completely different point of view. He's not a killer.
But our love is based on trust. I burned it in a car. Where is the ribbon that you made? You wore it for Sunday lemonade. Where's that red ribbon that you made? You kissed me and told me be brave. The Queen speaks of days.
Decided to make this song on one chord, on a D chord, and Tom came up with a great idea of strumming this on cello. It's how we recorded the ship's bell. That's much too heavy.
Loads of reverb.
Up until Mega Man, it's basically a melancholy mood, and it varies between quiet and very loud and dynamic, but it's quite suppressed. And then it suddenly just breaks free in Mega Man and doesn't go back.
More sort of sense of
and to express myself,
sort of sharing of that, others,
my friend, is very hard to do.
The sun that you hide from will find you.
Straightforward, transparent,
anyway.
So the last part of Mega Man, how everything can be fine, and the mandolin song is just mandolin and whistling, and a little bit of percussion, and then Supersonic Morning to finish the album off as like a pure celebration of life and the universe and everything. Supersonic Morning is about waking up dead in space with your favourite rock stars. I did find out when I was researching this that there is the Lennon crater. John Lennon has a crater on the moon named after him.
Wow.
So we've got John Lennon and George Harrison forming a band with Elvis.
Let's hear this part.
John and George form a band.
At the end for the last double chorus, which is really cool. Is that 10 or 12 of us?
Yeah, 10.
Semi-professional singers.
Some musicians that are not really trained singer, and some people who really went for it without knowing what they're like, up to, and without singing skills.
How did you get them to sing like this?
We filled them full of Jägermeister. They were a bit shy at the beginning. That's you at the end, isn't it? What are you saying? Keep going.
Again!
That's the end of the song. The last sound recorded on the album. It's a spinning top from Indonesia. You ready?
Yeah.